Welcome back to the Barbell Medicine YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Jordan Feigenbaum. We have Dr. Austin Baracchi in the studio, live, in the flesh. That's real. He's in town this week, and we decided to answer some questions from the internet. This is for the old MISC forums from bodybuilding.com. Is bulking and cutting the best method for long-term hypertrophy? I just don't know how you're going to get around it, is the deal. So when you go look at actual scientific evidence on this in bodybuilders, or people who identify as bodybuilders, because it's not like they've all competed, which is also weird. Like in the literature, you're like, do they send out a flyer like, are you a bodybuilder? You want to sign up for this study? Yeah. And it's like, how do you make sure, like, show me your NPC card. The people will gain more lean body mass as when they gain more weight. So the more weight you gain in a given time frame, they tend to gain more lean body mass. They also gain more fat mass during that time too. So, and there's a huge inter-individual variation with how much lean body mass that people are gonna gain and how much fat mass that people are gonna gain too. So, you know, you could have even twins, like groups of twins fed the same amount of calorie surplus, and one group of twins that are identical are gonna gain way more lean body mass compared to the other group of twins. If you wanna get bigger and gain more muscle mass, I don't see a way around, like, you're gonna have to go into a calorie surplus at some point. And then likely you're going to have to go to periods of time where you're reducing fat mass. As far as what's the best, like, stair step model versus like a, you know, bulk, then cut, and then maintenance. I don't know that I have hard feelings on that. I do tend to prefer having weight stabilization periods at every step of the game. So, I mean, when people gain weight, they gain a significant amount of muscle mass. I want them to like maintain that weight. And then when people lose weight, lose body fat, I want them to maintain that lower weight, this weight stabilization period for a couple weeks before they, you know, do anything with their calories. You might set yourself up for failure if you do not have these weight stabilization phases, particularly after weight loss. People are like, I just lost weight, I'm prime, I'm super anabolic, I'm gonna gain all this lean body mass quickly. And it's like, actually the biggest signal that your body has physiologically is to restore fat mass.
Yeah.
Like, so yeah, you're the most anabolic you ever be, but for fat mass, not for muscle
not
mass.
Not the cool kind.
Yeah. Not the cool kind, yeah. So that's the approach I tend to do. With the understanding that gaining a lot of lean body mass is going to take a long time. It should be a slow process. That's why, like, when people are like, how much of a surplus do I need to be in? I'm like, it's got small, 250 calories, maybe 500 calories. And then it's going to take a long time for you to do this anyway. And gaining weight rapidly is a good way to gain a lot of fat mass rapidly, unless you have great genetics, right? And gaining fat mass rapidly is probably not the move, particularly from a health standpoint. So yeah, I don't know what the best method is for long-term hypertrophy, if it's like, again, just cycling, but bulking and cutting, but I do like the weight stabilization phases, and I like making sure that people are the good candidates for either goal. So if you're already carrying too much fat mass,
don't bulk.
Correct, yeah, if your BMI is 30 or above, Do not pass go, do not collect $200, don't bulk. If your waist circumference is approaching that sort of cut point where you have an increased rate of obesity-related diseases, which there's a, you know, it's specific to your ethnicity, it's about 37 inches for guys, for example, don't bulk. And in fact, you probably should lose weight, that'd probably be better. Anything else you wanna add to that?
Yeah, I agree with the fact that, or with the idea that you're probably not going to be able to get around it. I think that there's similarly, there, to the extent that there even is a best way to go about it,
right?
Yeah. It is probably going to vary between people. Like the super freaky genetic people, there may be a better strategy for them. And then for people at the other end, you know, might be in the other direction. The problem is that, like you said, this is a very, very long process. And so we don't have any trials comparing bulking and cutting group to like people who just steadily maintain like 100 to 200 calorie surplus for like decades and see who gets more jacked like 20 years later.
Yeah.
So we can't necessarily know or predict.
Yeah, short-term studies, yeah.
Life is gonna, you know, probably like in I've never deliberately like aggressively bulked or cut. I've like gradually gained weight primarily for strength performance, not necessarily with any hypertrophy, you know, goals myself. But then like, you know, hospital work gets tough and I unintentionally cut because shit happens. And so I've kind of effectively ended up in that situation just as a result of life. But yeah, that's all I would add.
Yeah, I like that.